our core values that I find particularly important, which one is reality is known through reason, one of my favorites, and then meaning comes through making a difference. And that's, these days, that's very important. So anyway, now that we've done that, we're gonna start out with a couple of songs. We are our musical guest today. I have a little bio here on David Dietz. And let me start with that. We've seen David before. He's currently residing in Houston, Texas. He's pursuing a master's degree at Rice University Shepherd School of Music. He's performed across the US and Europe and is equally comfortable in solo, chamber, and orchestral settings. David became a member of the York Symphony Orchestra in 2012 at the age of 14. Well, you make me feel old, David, I'm sorry, but that's, wow. And he won the Harrisburg Symphony Youth Orchestra Concerto Competition in 2014, an orchestra of which he was a principal cello from 2012 to 2014. I want to just take a second to have you look behind him at Nikki Song. She, unfortunately, I did not get any bio for Nikki, and I'm really sorry for that, because She's actually in the doctoral program, so she's kind of the head of this little group that we have here today. And so anyway, I guess she's put some information on the chat room, so you can kind of find out more about her there. So anyway, we're gonna get a couple of pieces from David and Nikki here, so please take it away.
Okay, great. Thanks so much for having us. We always really like playing here. Just by hearing my bio or checking out Nikki's website, you would think that you're gonna hear classical music this morning, but hopefully we don't disappoint you too much. We're actually not gonna play classical music. We're gonna play some jazz standards, which is a style that we both really like, but we don't often get to play in our regular, you know, professional lives. So that's one of the reasons we really like playing here. We can kind of you know, do some different things than what we normally do. So we're going to start out by a standard called Misty. I'm not sure who, do you know who wrote Misty? It was made really popularized by Ella Fitzgerald. That's a very, that was the famous rendition. And we're going to start with that. And then we're going to play a Gershwin standard called Someone to Watch Over Me. So thank you and enjoy. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Nikki and David. That was beautiful. It really is just such a classy addition to our programs. You guys have always done that for us. Thank you very much. Okay, so I guess we're ready to move into our community sessions. I think we'll have two or three of them today. You're gonna try to squeeze in
three of them? Yes, we can squeeze in a few.
Okay.
At least a couple.
I'm in unknown territory here, so Abhishek, why don't you just...
So we're basically gonna switch to breakout rooms. And for those of you watching on Facebook, we will be switching to a break mode essentially, and you will see you'll see a break room, and we'll come back after 20 minutes. And,
A couple of comments, the usual ones we do. We're going to post the link to donate and to sign up for our weekly newsletter in the chat room. While we're no longer meeting in physical space, we're still paying speakers, musicians, and expenses like our storage facility and things like that. So, as usual, if you are enjoying our efforts here to get together, please consider donating if you are able to. We would very much appreciate it. And with that, we're going to have one last song from Nikki and David. So if Nikki and David would take it away, that would be great.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thanks again for having us this morning. We had a lot of fun. Our final piece will be a old standard titled It Could Happen to You. And this one was made famous by Chet Baker.
Thank you. Okay, so thank you everyone for joining us today, and a special thanks to Nikki and David for performing. Be sure this evening, if you can, to join us for another coronavirus conversation with Richard and Will. Keep an eye out for our future emails, Facebook posts, meetups, however you keep in touch with us or our future gatherings. I guess we're going to keep the meeting live for a little while here if people want to stick around and visit. And have a great week, and we'll see you next weekend.